Hello friends, welcome to my channel Master the Monster. Are you the one who think math is a monster? Are you frustrated with your heavy mathematical calculations? Are you haunted by the homeworks given by your math teacher? Are you annoyed about your mathematics exam? Now you can stop worrying. With little interest and regular practice, you can master the monster. All that you need to do is just subscribe to my channel, so that you can join with me to overcome your fear for maths. Class 10, CBSE Maths, Chapter 1, Real Numbers. Having discussed already about the Euclid's division lemma and algorithm, and also have solved problems in our previous videos, now we enter into the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. In order to learn the fundamental theorem of arithmetic more easily, we need to know the divisibility test for numbers. Okay, I could hear you say, oh, divisibility test is very simple and I knew it already. Yeah, of course you knew it already. But the sad truth is that you may not remember it now. Okay, if you say that you still have the divisibility test clear in your memory, then come on, try to factorize 437. Could you factorize it without any difficulty? If yes, then you are superb. If no, then let's learn it again. Now here, I have made a small recap of divisibility test for numbers from 1 to 20. Okay, now we'll see the divisibility test. Before entering into divisibility test, what does that word divisible mean? You say divisible, isn't it? So what do you mean by saying a number A is divisible by another number? So we say that the number A is divisible by another number if we divide A by B and we get the remainder to be 0. Okay, then we say that A is divisible by B. That is, for example, when I divide 15 by 5, the quotient is 3 and the remainder is 0. Hence, I can say 15 is divisible by 5. So, okay, I can also say the smaller number, that is 5, is a factor of 15, and the bigger number 15 is a multiple of 5. Always factor should be less than the number and multiple should be greater than the number. Don't get confused, right? Okay. Now, what is meant by divisibility test then? So divisibility test is nothing but it is a shortcut method. Otherwise, it is a small rule defined to find whether the given integer is divisible by another integer or not without actual division. That is, for example, I have given you 15 divided by 5, isn't it? So you can divide 15 by 5, get remainder 0, and then conclude that, yeah, 15 is divisible by 5. So without actual division also, we can check whether this number is divisible by 5 using a certain rule called the divisibility test. So that's what the main purpose of divisibility test is. Let's see the rules for divisibility test number 1 to 20, one by one. Okay, let me start with 1. So what is the rule for divisibility by 1? The rule is that all integers are divisible by 1. There is no rule. We obviously see that every number is divisible by 1. So there is nothing to check for divisibility by 1. Let's pass on to divisibility by 2. Okay. When will you say that a number is divisible by 2? If the last digit of the number is an even number. That is, the last digit of a given number should be either 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. If it is one among those 5 numbers, then we say that the number is divisible by 2. Right? For example, you consider the number 176. Now, what is the last digit of this number? The last digit is 6. Is it even? Yeah, it's an even number. So I conclude this 176 is divisible by 2. For example, you consider another number 671. What is the last digit of this number? So in order to check the divisibility by 2, I verify the last digit of the number. So the last digit of the number here is 1, which is an odd number. So I conclude 671 is not divisible by 2. So this is how I check whether a given number is divisible by 2 or not without dividing it. Okay, now let's pass on to divisibility by 3. When will you say that a number is divisible by 3? If the sum of digits is divisible by 3. So the rule is very simple for divisibility by 3. For example, you consider a number 216. Now I'm going to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. So what is the rule? You read it again. The sum of digits is divisible by 3. So I have to find the sum of digits. So let me separate the digits and add them. So the answer is the sum of digits. So what is the sum of digits? The sum of digits is 18. And we clearly see that this 18 is divisible by 3. So sum of digits is divisible by 3. That automatically means the whole number, that is the given number 216, is also divisible by 3. Okay. Now let me check it for another number, 542. Now what I have to do, I have to find the sum of digits. So let me separate the digits, sum them, and the sum here is 11, which is not divisible by 3. So the sum of digits is not divisible by 3. So I conclude the given number is also not divisible by 3. So this is the rule for divisibility by 3. Right? You have to check the sum of digits. Okay, now let's pass on to divisibility by 4. Okay, a number is said to be divisible by 4 if the number formed by the last two digits is divisible by 4. That is, for example, you consider a number 1428. Now let me check whether this number is divisible by 4 or not. Okay, what is the rule given? The rule given is the number formed by the last two digits is divisible by 4. So let me see what is the number formed by the last two digits. Wow, the number formed by the last two digits is 28, and I very well know that this 28 is divisible by 4. So my rule says if the number formed by the last two digits is divisible by 4, then the entire number is divisible by 4. So I conclude 1428 is divisible by 4. Okay. Now let me consider another number, 7053. Now let me check whether this is divisible by 4 or not. So let me separate the last two digits. The number formed is 53, which is not divisible by 4. So I conclude 7053 is not divisible by 4. So this is how we check the divisibility by 4 without actually dividing the number by 4. Okay, now let me go for divisibility by 5. The divisibility by 5 is very simple because it just says that check whether the last digit is 0 or 5. If the last digit is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Let's, for example, let's consider the number 395. The last digit here is 5. And our rule says that if the last digit is either 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. So we conclude 395 is divisible by 5. Now let's consider another number, 507. Here, let me check for the divisibility by taking the last digit. The last digit is 7. It's neither 0 nor 5. So I conclude the number is not divisible by 5. Right? Now let's go for divisibility by 6. Divisibility by 6 doesn't matter because 6 is a composite number and we very well know the factors of 6 are 2 and 3. 2 into 3 is equal to 6. So if you can apply them for the number, both the rules, and find out whether the number is divisible by 6, right? Now let's get into divisibility by 7. So this, when will you say that a number is divisible by 7? That is, when you double the last digit and subtract it from the number formed by the remaining digits, you get a resultant number which is divisible by 7. Then the number is divisible by 7. Otherwise, it's not. That is, for example, you consider a number 672. So what my rule says is double the last digit first. So double the last digit. Let me double the last digit. The last digit here is 2, and doubling it means multiplying it by 2, right? And then subtract it from the number formed by the remaining digits. That's my rule, isn't it? Okay, then by doing so, what result do I get? The result is 63. So the resultant number is divisible by 7. So my actual number is also divisible by 7. That's what the rule says. To understand the divisibility by 7, you double the last digit, subtract it from the number formed by the remaining digits. If the resultant number is divisible by 7, then the entire number is divisible by 7. Okay, now let's see it more clear from another example. Consider 225. Let me check the divisibility by 7 for this number. So let me double the last digit. So separate the last digit, multiply by 2 and subtract it from the remaining digits so that I get the resultant to be 12. And we clearly know that this 12 is not divisible by 7, and hence I conclude this 225 is not divisible by 7. Okay, now when you perform the And when you apply the rule of divisibility by 7 for numbers, you get the resultant number to be 63, to be simple as in case of 63 and 12 sometimes. But sometimes you also get bigger numbers which you can't directly verify whether it is divisible by 7 or not. In that case, what you have to do is you have to apply the rule again and again until you get a simpler resultant number. Okay, let me explain it with an example. See here, suppose I have a number 12,264, and let me check whether this number is divisible by 7 or not. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to double the last digit. So the last digit here is 4. Let me double it and subtract it from the remaining number, so 1218. But see, I couldn't check this resultant number directly whether it is divisible by 7 or not, because it is not a small number, it's a large number. So I do is I apply the divisibility test again for this 1219. So let me apply the divisibility test for 1219. The last digit here is 8, so double 8 and subtract it from the remaining number, I get 105. Then again, let me apply the rule for 105. So the last digit is 5, double it, 10 minus 10 is 0. So now I got the resultant number to be simple, and I can directly see that 0 is divisible by 7, because 0 is divisible by all numbers. Resultant number 0 is divisible by 7. I concluded that 12,264 is also divisible by 7. This is how we check the divisibility by 7 for a bigger number. So not only for 7, for any number, you can apply the divisibility test again and again if the resultant number is a bigger number, so that you get a more simplified number and you can conclude whether it is divisible or not very easily, right? So for it is applicable for all numbers. Okay, now let me get into the divisibility by 8. When will you say that a number is divisible by 8? If the number formed by the last 3 digits is divisible by 8, then the entire number is divisible by 8. For example, you consider the number 14,808. So what the rule says? The rule says number formed by last 3 digits is divisible by 8. Here the number formed by last 3 digits is 808, which we clearly see that is divisible by 8. So I conclude the entire number is divisible by 8. Okay, so sometimes you consider number 12,273. The number formed by last 3 digits is 273. It's not divisible by 8. So we conclude saying the number, given number, is not divisible by 8. So if the last 3 digits is divisible by 8, we say that the entire number is divisible by 8, or else it's not divisible, right? Okay, we also see that this 8 is a composite number and it can be written 2 into 2 into 2, right? So I can also check the divisibility by 8 by dividing the number 3 times by 2. For example, you consider the first number 14,808. Let me divide it once by 2. It is completely divisible. It is exactly divisible and leaves remainder 0, right? Again, the resultant number you divide by 2, that again is completely divisible by 2. Then that resultant number, let me divide by 2, I get an integer. I don't get any decimals or remainder. So a number that is divisible by 2 3 times and it leaves remainder 0, then I conclude that that number is divisible by 8. If not, it's not divisible by 8, right? Now let's see divisibility by 9. The divisibility by 9 is similar to divisibility by 3. The sum of digits should be divisible by 9. So that is similar to divisibility by 3. So consider the number. Let's sum the digits. Their sum is 18. 18 is divisible by 9, then the given number is divisible by 9. We get another number, find the sum of digits. The sum is 11, which is not divisible by 9. So I conclude the given number is not divisible by 9. So this is the same as divisibility by 3. Alright, okay, next we'll go for divisibility by 10. divisibility by 10 is as very easy. Everybody knows this rule. The last digit should be 0. That's all is the divisibility by 10. So when you consider a number 390, the last digit here is 0. So I say it's divisible by 10. Consider number 661. The last digit here is 1. So I conclude it's not equal to 0. Therefore, 661 is not divisible by 10. So this is the divisibility rule for 10. Now we'll pass on to divisibility by 11. Rule states that the difference between the sum of digits in even places and that in odd places is divisible by 11. See, this is an interesting rule and you'll really enjoy watching it, right? So what the rule says is the sum of digits in the difference between sum of digits in even places and odd places is divisible by 11. That's, for example, you consider a number 72,545. Let me check whether this number is divisible by 11 or not. So what I'm going to do is let me separate the digits from odd places, okay, and sum them. Similarly, I separate the digits from even places, sum them, and then find the difference. So this is what the rule says: the difference between the sum of digits in even places and that in odd places is divisible by 11. So when I sum them, I get the value to be 11. So this 11 is divisible by 11. Hence, I conclude the original number, that is 72,544, is also divisible by 11. We'll check the divisibility for one more number, 42,738. What we have to do, separate the odd digits first and then group them, sum them. Separate the even digits, group them, sum them. Then find the difference of the two. We get the resultant to be 14. Which is not divisible by 11. So I conclude 42,738 is also not divisible by 11. We need not get into the divisibility of composite numbers because that doesn't matter at all. So let's focus only on the prime numbers. So let me go to the divisibility by 13. Okay, when will you say that this number is divisible by 13? Multiply the last digit and add it to the number formed by remaining digits. If the resultant is divisible by 13, then the entire number is divisible by 13. So it's as simple as that. And hereafter, almost all the divisibility test will be of the same format. That is, take the last digit, multiply it by this by some number, add or subtract it to the remaining digits. That's what going to be the remaining rules also. So in 13, we take the last digit, multiply by 4. So for example, you consider a number 533. Let me take the last digit, multiply by 4. Then what is given the rule? Add it to the remaining number. So when I add it to the remaining number, the resultant is 65. And I see that the 65 is divisible by 13. Therefore, I conclude 533 is divisible by 13. Okay, now let me consider the next number, another number, 672. Let me take the last digit, multiply it by 4, add it to the remaining number. I get the resultant to be 75, which is not divisible by 13. So I conclude 672 is not divisible by 13. This is how I check the divisibility by 13. So next, divisibility by 17, multiply the last digit by 5 and subtract it from the number formed by the remaining digits. The resultant must be divisible by 17. So I have told you always, we are going to take the last digit, multiply it by some number, add or subtract it from the remaining number. So that's what we are doing in divisibility by 17 also. We take the last digit, multiply it by 5 and subtract it from the remaining number. So the resultant number, if it is divisible by 17, we conclude that the given number is also divisible or else not. So let us see through examples. 8986. So let me check whether this number is divisible by 17 or not. For that, let me take the last digit, multiply it by 5, subtract it from the remaining number and get the resultant. It is 68, which is very well divisible by 17. Okay, so I conclude the given number is divisible by 17. This is how I check for the divisibility of 17, divisibility by 17, right? Now let me explain it through some other example. 876. Take the last digit, multiply it by 5, subtract it from the remaining number. That gives the resultant 57, which is not divisible by 17. So we conclude 876 is not divisible by 17. To divisibility by 19. So that is also going to be of the same format. Take the last digit, multiply by 2 and add it to the number formed by remaining digits. Right, consider a number 475. Let me check whether this number is divisible by 19 or not. Take the last digit, multiply it by 2, add it to the remaining digits so that you get the value to be 57, which is divisible by 19. So I conclude 475 is divisible by 19. Let's apply the rule for one more number, 575. Take the last digit, multiply it by 2, add it to the remaining digits. You get the resultant to be 67, which is not divisible by 19. So I conclude 475 is not divisible by 19. So this is how we check the numbers divisible by 19 or not. You can check the divisibility for composite numbers using these prime numbers itself, right? So thus I have made for the divisibility test for numbers from 1 to 20. Now, having refreshed our memory, let's go to learn the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So